I think the nominees for Best Actor will be Daniel Day-Lewis for 9, Jeff Bridges for Crazy Heart, Matt Damon for The Informant, George Clooney for Up in the Air, and I know you two will disagree with me on the last one, but Nicolas Cage for Bad Lieutenant, Port of Call, New Orleans.
Okay, Francis, Merrick?
My choices that I think will be chosen for Best Actor are Morgan Freeman for Invictus, Jeff Bridges for Crazy Heart, Jeffrey Renner for Hurt Locker.
Jeremy Renner
for Hurt Locker, George Clooney for Up in the Air, and Colin Firth for A Single Man.
Oh my God, I agree with Merrick all over again.
Oh my God.
All right, well, I don't agree with Francis. All right, so we're going to have to ask Francis to defend his choices again. Okay, now Matt Damon, did you say?
For The Informant.
Okay.
It was just one of those roles where he was playing such an eccentric character that he had to do it in such a way where it would have been complex just to play him as a sympathetic man, even though he does some unscrupulous things in the movie.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought Matt Damon really got to him as like this guy who really had no idea what he was doing. He had some strong psychological issues. And I thought, to me, that definitely qualifies for a Best Actor slot, especially from another great movie from Steven Soderbergh.
And there was another one you had.
Oh, wait, Francis, I don't remember. Were you a big fan of The Informant? I just don't remember.
No, it wasn't in his top 10.
It wasn't in my top 10, but I still like the movie.
You like the movie, yeah. Okay.
Well, what was the other one that were you... dared to disagree with me and Merrick.
I also said Daniel Day-Lewis for 9.
We've
already spoke about, you know, the issues with 9. And again, I think Daniel Day-Lewis, amazing actor, he definitely deserves a slot for whatever he does, because it's clear he pours his heart and soul more than any other actor into any performance he gives.
You said to me, Daniel Day-Lewis is God. I think you're kind of right most of the time, but not in this part.
It's not happening.
And lastly, Nicolas Cage.
Oh, Nicolas Cage. Yeah. Yes, well, we really differ. Yes. So we only had 2 out of 3.
It's just when Nicolas Cage does the right movie for that plays to his talents, he runs away with it and does amazing things, like Leaving Las Vegas, an adaptation. I thought that Bad Lieutenant was just one of those movies where every eccentric mannerism of Nicolas Cage played well to the movie's strengths. And overall, I thought it was one of those performances where people will look back and think, he was a really good actor. And I thought that Bad Lieutenant, overall, he carried that movie. And it was just such a complex film by Werner Herzog that I think it should definitely get some attention.
Well, I guess the question is, where did you agree with Merrick and myself?
I just wanted to say, you know, Francis, I hear what you're saying, and I remember you talking a lot about these things in our previous show. But remember now, we're talking about who the Academy is going
Fair
to
enough.
Nominate.
Right, not,
no.
not who and, you and, want
like,
to
Like,
win.
I don't think Nicolas Cage is going to, you know, nobody saw that film. To be honest with you,
that's
nobody
right.
saw
I was
the gonna, Bad
yeah,
Lieutenant.
You're right.
And I agree with your fervor about enjoying the performances, but I don't think it's going to work in terms of who the Academy is going
to
nominate.
I mean, I respect that, and I totally agree with you. But that being said, I like to just say...
To hell with the Academy.
But that being said, it's like, I feel like I'm going to say these performances is like, these are the people who I think, worst comes to worst, they don't get it, but I know where I stand.
Well, you're not going to be fired. You know that. But well, what were the two before we... what were the two...
We agreed.
George Clooney.
Jeff
yes.
Bridges.
And George Clooney.
Right. And Joe, well, those are the two front runners. Let me just throw that in. Next!